What's up? It's Carlos with Toy Gigante.
And I'm Mary.
And today we're going to talk about Toys R Us.
Wasn't there something you wanted to tell me?
Yeah.
Yeah?
What I don't want to grow up. Oh. I'm a Toys R Us kid.
Yeah.
At Toys R Us, there's a million toys that I can play with.
It's true.
From bikes to trains to video games.
It's the biggest toy store there is. I don't want to grow up.
Because if I did,
we wouldn't be Toys R Us kids. And now that it's official.
Yeah, they're closing down.
Now that the liquidation sales have started and they are closing down.
We just want to talk about it.
We're just going to talk about it a little bit. So,
when did it start?
It started in 1957 in Maryland by a guy named Charles Lazarus. Who unfortunately just passed away, so our condolences.
May rest in peace.
And he started it because I guess back before 1957, you could really only buy toys during Christmas time at department stores. And he figured there was actually a bigger
demand
for toys
all year round.
All year round, so he created the first Toys R Us.
Wow.
Yeah.
In a time machine. I love a time machine right now.
We could go buy a Yukadoodle.
I could buy that BB gun from Toy Story.
Toy Story or A Christmas Story?
From both. A Christmas Story, and I'm sure there's one in Toy Story.
We could go get a Woody. We can go
Woody
get
doll.
A Woody doll. Woody doll and Jesse and Bullseye.
Bullseye.
We're
a little bummed out. We want to keep it positive, though, but...
Yeah, we normally like to keep things more positive here on Toy Gigante, but it's kind of a sad day.
Because we would go every Friday to Toys R Us and spend our hard-earned money on stuff that we'd like.
That's what he says. For me, it was just date night, and I was just really happy to be out of the house on a date. At Toys R Us, because we're kind of dorky like that.
That's what we do. We go out and go find cool stuff.
Yeah. Meet up with friends sometimes.
A lot of times I'd meet up with friends and be like, I'll just see you at Toys R Us, and then we'd go see what they had and stuff like that. But we were there like at least 3 times a month at Toys R Us.
You're being a little,
generous?
Generous would mean, no, he's hiding things. We, 3 times a week is more accurate.
Whatever. Sometimes I was...
The manager lady at our TRU knows us by sight, so...
Yeah, she knows.
She knows us by sight and almost by name. We feel a little bad, you know, because, like...
I'm feeling a lot for, like, that and the
for
employees...
The employees. You know,
they're cool.
Not just for us, but for all these people that are about to lose their jobs. And
so if you're watching this, it's gonna be okay, and we feel for you.
And we appreciate all the help you've given us, and all the wonderful toys you've sold us.
And sorry you didn't get the 10% off.
Yeah, we're sorry we never applied for that credit card, but really we don't need it. So.
Well, not anymore.
So. Carlos.
Yes.
What was one of your favorite memories?
I have so many. But I remember going down the toy aisle, and it was huge, and I was a little kid. And I remember seeing the Defiant up on the shelves, and I was like, wow, I'll never get that.
Yeah.
Too expensive, too big.
Yeah.
You know, and I'd go all the way down to the G.I. Joe aisle.
I'm not allowed to talk about his Defiant anymore.
No, don't.
Not allowed to talk about it.
And I would get my Ninja Turtles, G.I. Joes, Transformers, everything. It was just great. That's one of my memories.
Yeah.
What do you think?
What do I think? What's one of my memories?
Yeah.
Well, I'm a pessimist. But one of my memories was, and it's a little thing, like...
Don't be glib.
one of my favorite memories, well, and it's not even like a favorite, but like I remember one of my first times going to the Toys R Us near my house, like, and it was an adventure to get there because it was really far from the house. It was I remember everything being yellow and orange and brown. Because mm-hmm. It had to have been the early 80s.
It was like Burger King colors.
Yeah, it was totally, well, it was early Burger King colors. So it induced
hunger in your toys.
Yeah, it induced me wanting to eat all my toys. But I remember the entrance to the Toys R Us would be like, when you're facing the store, it would be on the front right hand side. And the girls' toy section, because it was kind of like Costco. It's like, it feels like Costco, where it was just these long aisles. It seemed so huge at that age, where it was like these long, magical aisles of awesomeness.
Yeah, back in the 80s.
And the girls' section was way the heck over there. And you had to go through all these things that were cool, but it wasn't what you were looking for, because what you wanted was in that far left-hand corner.
That little section for girls.
It was probably about
four
aisles long. You know, like, and it was not even the whole aisle, and...
So then at the very corner on the bottom was your gem section.
It really was like that, yeah. It was like you had to go down the Barbie aisle, and the Barbies were all, like, massive, and they would just take... And I'm just kind of like, pfft. I mean, yes, this is a Barbie, but pfft, you know? And then the gems were just, like, this tiny little section, and they'd be there next to the Cabbage Patch Kids. Well, not next to the Cabbage Patch Kids, but, you know, like, Strawberry Shortcake, the Cabbage Patch Kids, the My Little Ponies. Like, I was into ponies and gems, so, like, I always kind of ignored Barbie, you know? But it was, like... But the thing about it was, is it was like some magical reward, because you had to go really far to get to it, because it felt so massive. And then I have a little brother... And my little brother's, the boys' toys were always before the girls' toys, so we would always stop at the boys' stuff first, and then it would, so by the time you get there, it was like this magical reward for child patience.
You're like, there's...
Which there wasn't a whole lot of.
Here's your one gem every 2 years.
Yeah, and then of course, you know, it's like your parents are on a budget, and then I'd be like, I want this one, and they're like, not gonna happen. And then you'd be like, but, and they're like, how does it feel to want and not receive? That was my dad's favorite. How does it feel to want and not receive?
I was spoiled, but in return, I got to live in hell, so it evened out.
Yeah, it evened out. You might have had a lot of toys, but you got...
Toy hell.
You had toy hell. Yeah. I mean, we're trying to keep it positive.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
We both went down emo bill. We went too personal. A little TMI there.
Let me talk about the video games in the early 90s, how cool it was to go to the video game section and, you know...
Well, don't just intro it. Just start, get going. Get to it, buddy.
Calm down.
Okay, sorry.
So, the video game section was huge, and they'd have these displays, the window displays, and they'd have the Power Glove, the NES, and finally the Sega Genesis. It was there, and you could look at it through glass, and on one side they had the systems, and on the other side they had all the games, and you would just go up to like the video game side, and then you'd pick the game you wanted, and then you'd get this card, and you bring it to the register, and then you'd go to this little box office, and then you'd give the receipt to the guy, and he'd go back and get your video game. And
we never had video games, but I remember having seeing the cards all the time.
Well, I was so pumped because behind the guy there'd be like stacks of NES games, and I just wanted to reach in there and grab all the video games.
Yeah. So, okay. Video game section.
Yeah.
Giant aisles.
Yeah.
Didn't you bring something to show people today that was an exclusive?
This is a G.I. Joe exclusive Night Force vehicle. It's a G.I. Joe Shark.
Would you like to put it on the Lazy Susan?
I forgot the...
And
I forgot the name of the vehicle.
Of which we know he'll now be banned from all of his G.I. Joe groups.
But it's an exclusive from, I think, the 1990s or 89. Oh my gosh. I just found it, sorry.
He just found it. Just
and
before Bill.
This is one of the cool exclusives that...
Well, the Night Force were all really awesome vehicles.
They were. They were like remakes of classic.
I loved the neon orange on everything.
Yeah, and these stickers glow in the dark, too.
Yeah. Anything that glows in the dark and neon, I'm a
sucker. And one thing I'm going to miss is that, like, besides all the exclusives, is that, so one thing I really liked was that, and this is something that you can't do online, is you buy a figure and you look at it and you can get the one with the best paint apps. I like to get the best boxes.
Yeah, on the internet you can't really do that.
No, it's just not the same.
No.
You know, some figures have paint smudges, and I just get really particular about my stuff.
Yeah.
I just want the best for my money, so that's something I won't be able to do anymore.
Let's see. I have two favorite exclusives. You may have your shark.
Thanks.
Pad. So, not the doll, but the sweatshirt. This is not my original sweatshirt. That got lost years ago.
That was from back in the day, huh?
This is from back in the day, early 80s. They would sell these exclusive sweatshirts for you to pick up for relatively cheap, I believe, for your Barbie, or your 11 to 12 inch doll. And so that would be one. And then my second all-time favorite is my Star Wars collecting got bad in the mid to late 90s, and Toys R Us had this really awesome set of
Jar Jar Binks,
yeah. of three 12 inch Star Wars dolls, and one was Luke from A New Hope, and one was a Han from Empire, and then the third was Princess Leia from Jedi in her Boosh costume, her bounty hunter costume, including thermal detonator.
And
Luke and Han were cool, but I totally admit I spent quite a bit of money on that set just so I could have Princess Leia as a bounty hunter. And I still have her. She's just
somewhere
in a box safely put away.
Yeah.
But
so
those would
toys,
be
so many memories.
So little space to put them all out.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
But yeah, so I mean, we've got our good memories, which we're going to hold on to a lot more than our bad memories, and it will be missed.
It's been a great experience.
Yeah.
We'll always be Toys R Us kids.
Always.
And yeah, we just wanted to say that.
Yeah, we just wanted to
add.
No, just
just be positive, enjoy your toys, they're there for fun.
We know that this is not the end, it's just a metamorphosis, that the toy industry is just, you know, making a shift again.
Yeah, I remember we lost KB's.
And we all bounced back from that.
Baby toys at the mall.
Yeah. Which, yes, we have heard that there's a rumor that it's coming back.
We don't know.
We're not sure yet, you know, but we have heard that from friends and family members trying to make us feel better.
Support your local mom and pop stores, too.
Yeah. I mean, that really is the best way.
Local, and keep buying toys. It's fun.
You know.
Buy them wisely and have fun. Keep it positive,
and
cool.
We'll be back next week with
something.
All
right.
So
until next time.
Till next time.